everybody, this is Mazzy616 here, and welcome back to the channel. Today we are checking out the Azorius Guild Kit. Now, I've never opened one of these before, and I saw it and I was like, this looks pretty cool. So apparently these are the level-headed ones in Ravnica, if I remember correctly. All three Ravnica blocks. So, looks like we actually get some sort of Sphinx. We get two Sphinxes, some wicked-looking planes. Cool little symbol sticker, a pin that you can throw at somebody, and a spin down life counter, which I admit I do collect the life counters. So I'm not sure how you're supposed to open these. Probably where it says open in really nice big letters. Well, not really nice big letters, but it says it in letters. It's however we want to do this. Oops, sorry if I shook the table. All right, so let's check this out. All right, here's some inserts. Standards of behavior. Oh wow, they really go into depth. It's actually pretty cool. And it's got your card list for you if you just want to keep a hold of the card list. Oh, check out that artwork. All I can think of is Palpatine. I am the Senate. Just have a little bit of fun. All right, we get a wicked looking Triforce style sticker for all my Zelda nerds out there. And then nifty little deck box. Doesn't even have the name on it. All right, so we're gonna lift this up because I'm pretty sure this splits in half, or we have to do the hokey pokey to turn ourselves around. There's a very limit. Oh, hey, check out the pen. It's an actual like little pen, not just a little counter thing. That's actually not bad quality. A little backpack pen for you. I like the life counter. I think white and blue looks really good. Especially, I love Legend of Zelda, and that is one wicked looking kind of indention there. All right, so before we go any further, we're gonna go ahead and sleeve up this Sphinx. I love the little thing right there. Let's read the flavor test. I serve only justice, but through that duty, I serve all of Ravnica. You control, you may draw a card. Whenever a creature attacks you or a planeswalker you control, you can draw a card. That seems slightly interesting, and it's a flying creature, which I didn't know big rocks could fly, but hey, you know, to each their own. I do like that. It almost looks like the Avatar people. Blue Avatar, not the last Airbender M. Night Shyamalan disaster. And if you think that movie was good, well, you don't have to watch the videos. That movie was horrible. All right, and of course I can't figure it out. There we go. All right, we're gonna open this up, crack it open, see what we get. I'm sure there's an actual, well, we can see what we get in the list, but let's take a look at each of the cards and see what they look like, see what they do, have a little bit of fun with it, spend some time. There we go. All right, and of course we'll be sleeving up all the rares. If there's a card over $2, I'll throw it up. Pride of the Clouds. Sphinx of Foresight. That's not bad. You may reveal this card from your opening hand. If you do, scry 3 at the beginning of your first upkeep. There we go. At the beginning of your upkeep, scry 1. Not bad. Lavina of the 10th. Legendary creature, human soldier, protection from red. Whenever it enters battlefield, detain each non-land permanent your opponent controls with converted mana cost 4 or less. They can't attack or block, and they're like, that's not bad. I kind of like some of these. Wind Reaver Elemental. Check out that wicked looking sword. All right. Insperia the Inscrutable. Legendary Creature Sphinx. These are giving you some pretty decent commander cards. Archeon of the Triumvirate. Unbreakable Formation. Detention Sphere. What is the value of this? Render Silent. Oh wow. Dovescape. Man, some of these have got to be valuable. And a Mythic Sphinx Revelation. You gain X life and draw X cards. And you've got Warrant and Warden. Put target attacking or blocking creature on top of its own library. Or create a 4/4 white and blue Sphinx creature token flying in vigilance. Man, this thing does not token bird flying. You can take the tokens out. These do look really cool though. I don't know why they're in the middle of the deck. That doesn't make any sense. Judge is familiar. Second there, I thought this was a commander deck. Stoic Ephemerae. Court Hesier. Not bad. Spirit of the Spires. This actually doesn't look half bad for a deck. I'm not a blue-white player, but this seems like a lot of fun to play, actually. Oh, you got my Drake. Gotta love my Drake. It's an expensive Drake, but gotta love my Drake. Return a land you control to its owner's hand. But you can tap for both. That's actually not bad. We're gonna set those aside. How many did it give you? It gave you four of those? Then, of course, you got the Guild Gates, which always enter the battlefield tapped. Let's check out these planes, though. How many different? They're all the same, but they do have that really cool symbol at the bottom. All right, we'll go through the planes. Maybe the islands look really good, too. I do like that. Give me a minute. I'm blanking out. Azorius. I do like the way that the background looks for those. There we go. All right, Sky Tether. Azorius Signet. One tap, add one of each. Get a couple of those. Summary Judgment deals 3 damage to target tapped creature. If you cast a spell during your main phase, it deals 5 damage. Azorius Charm, choose one, you gain lifelink, draw a card, put attacking or blocking creature on top of its owner's library. Dramatic Rescue, gain 2 life. Key Rune, what's this do? Becomes a 2/2 white and blue bird artifact creature with flying until end of turn. That just looks cool. You gain 2 life and draw 2 cards. Alright. Depose and deploy. All in all, not actually a bad deck. I've got to give it that. I'd never thought to play blue-white before, to be honest. And I'm kind of wanting to actually play this deck. I did not see a Magic Arena. There's words to this that I can't think of right now. Magic Arena code. Otherwise, this might be one I save for myself. You guys will know more about the value than I will. It should pop up on screen as we were going through if any of these cards were highly valuable. I'm really hoping I'm not making any of you guys cringe by me picking them up right now like this. Thank you guys for checking out the video. I'd give this a solid B. This looks like it'd be a lot of fun to play. It's not going to be competitive, but for casual with your friends at the card shop, this actually seems like it'd be a fun deck to play. Maybe a few modifications here and there, but hey guys, as for the video today, that's it. Hope you guys had a good time. Like, subscribe, share, comment, let everybody know what you think. If you guys want me to open something special, throw it down in the comments. I'll see what I can do about getting a hold of it. Hope I can get a hold of it for a reasonable price. We can have a lot of fun. Other than that, guys, thank you so much for being. Hope you have a great day.